Hello friends, this is Mita. I work at Sports Check Canada. I follow Ricky Chadite, Astro Healer on YouTube. Thank you.
Now Mercury goes direct on the 18th along with Jupiter. Hello friends, this is Ricky Chadite from Astro Healer. On the 18th of October, Mercury is going direct. And on the same day, you'll see even Jupiter is getting direct. Jupiter is a planet of wisdom, expansion, knowledge. And here, Mercury, the planet of intelligence, communication. Mercury is all about travel, transportation, your siblings, and multitasking. All these are the characteristics of Mercury. See, on the 18th of October 2021, at around maybe 8:45 p.m., it is going direct after staying for 22 days in its own sign, Virgo. So now it is heading towards the sign of Libra. And it will enter into the sign of Libra on the 2nd of November. See, during this retrogression of Mercury, you must have realized few things. Either you are feeling very frustrated, very tensed, very stressed. Mercury normally, because it is a planet of communication, your communication goes a little you may fumble, you may say a wrong word, a wrong statement. And believe me, I realized it when even I was watching some news channel, some of the anchors also have committed some mistake. And due to communication, lot many things have happened, say, in the last few days. Now, since it is getting back to its on the track or direct, let us see how it is going to, once it gains the momentum, how it is going to affect each Lagna, right from Aries to Pisces. So let's see. As I always told you, that in my video, in the description, you will find a time stamp. So you don't have to go through the entire video. You may just select your Lagna or your Moon Rashi and just see what I have to say about that particular Lagna. Thank you so much. So friends, for Aries Lagna, see, Mercury happens to be the lord of your third and the sixth house, and now it is getting direct in the sixth house. Sixth house is a house which deals with daily wages. It deals with debts, loans, enemies, diseases, all those things. Mercury will get direct and it will come like a bang. When it is like, you will feel that the life has come back into you. Somewhere you got stuck and now there is a freedom, there is an opening for you. There will be a desire in you that you should start afresh. Let's start again. What be the thought? Okay. And you will have new experiences waiting for you. And there will be a sense of ambition also, which was lying dormant for a very long time. And you will start feeling once again that I need to move in a normal speed. You are going to see that whatever you were fighting over for a long time now, or with whomever you were having odds with, all those things will come to a standstill, and a new beginning is starting for you. I'm talking about Aries now. This is the time for improving your skill. You can have some create some extra time for yourself and get rid of any pointless paperwork which is not required actually, which is unnecessarily, you're just bundling it up. Now, income also is going to be average during this period now from the 18th of October, and there might be some possibility of tension also in the family, but that's not a major concern over here. Health wise, I would say that you will be physically perfectly fine. But maybe mentally, you will have little stress. due to the excess work pressure. We have to understand that Mercury is going to be in your sixth house, which is a Dusthana house. So I would request you to go for, if you can, practice some meditation or some yoga techniques. This was all for Aries. The next sign is Taurus. Now for Taurus, we have to understand that Mercury rules your second and your fifth house, and now it is getting direct in your fifth house. Fifth house is of education. It is it's a house of romance, love, children, and creative skills also is looked from this house. Now you will see that your skills, okay, can now after the 18th of October will come up, will shine in this period, and especially you will have a very good time to explore some creativity and some new innovations that you in your career front also. When the planet Mercury, which is a Karak of communication, you may, something will strike your mind and you will just snap out something and your head will like to say, oh, this is something that I always wanted and now it's just right in front of me. That is a situation that you will see. You are going to see that the life comes with ups and downs. It's with all the people, okay? And just because you have an occasional downs, it doesn't mean that all the avenues have come to an end. If you were seeing a lot of dips, now it's time for you to rise now. Mercury, when it opens the door for you from the 18th of October, you will start feeling, your partner or partner's feelings, okay? You'll see that, there is now honest conversation between both of you all. Financially, this time, you need to manage your expenses, finances, and keep a check on where are you spending money. And maybe the expenses go a little on a higher side. You have to just don't make very lavish buying. Control your lifestyle. So, and this is a festive, I've told you this, that it's a festive month. So maybe you want to spend money on lot many things, but keep a check on your expenses as well. On the personal level, I see that you will spend some good quality time with your friends, and there are chances that you may also get into, if you're not already into relationship, you may get into a new relationship and may meet some new people also. It is also a very favorable time for your children. So you will get some good news from your children also. Married life is good. If you want to play in share market, because fifth house is of speculation also. But there is an advice to you, avoid doing anything on an extreme. Okay, investing huge money could be a little risky, so play safe and play. Take advice of the expert people before doing so. The next sign is Gemini. For Gemini, it is the ruler of your first house and the fourth house, and it is opening up, going direct on the 18th October in the fourth house itself. Now, fourth house is all about comforts, is about luxury, about vehicles, about property, about your mother, your hometown, motherland. Now, with Mercury is also your lord, okay? So it is your lord. So you will be sensitive, and all these days, especially people who are Gemini and Virgo, your communication was getting a little, was in a trap, I would say. So now the monster is now on loose. During this period, you will focus and deal with all the matters practically as far as your career or profession is concerned. So you'll be very practical. Mercury, as it is a very practical planet, especially in the sign of Virgo. Then, for you, it will be the communication the clear communication, the honest communication will begin for you. This is an excellent time if you want to share your thoughts, your ideas, your concepts, and which will be appreciated by people or maybe your colleague, your seniors, whatever it is. You have been beating yourself up for some time, like, you know, up lately you're finding like, you know, oh, what's happening to me? And then why I am forgetting so many things, why things are not happening with me? And you thought that, you know, okay, maybe I'm getting into a bad habit of forgetting things. Now you are free, and you are free again to live your life without any confusion. So Mercury is now, that confusion is going, and you are all set. In personal life, I feel that, you know, you will get full support from your siblings, brothers, and you will be spending some quality time with your family member too. Maybe you or go out for some event or something, function with your family. Financially, you will be benefited in matter of property because it is the fourth house. Health wise, there might be some minor health trouble here and there. Hence, I would say ke just be a little careful of what you're eating, how you're eating, and eating timely or no. And if something is there, make sure that the treatment also comes right in time. So you will see that as Mercury goes direct, it will change your heart also. You will breathe much more easier now. And that means your life is getting easier. The next sign I shall be talking about is the sign of Cancer. Now, Mercury is ruling your 12th house and it is ruling your 3rd house. See, both the house talks about travel. 12th house is foreign land, foreign travel. 3rd house is short journeys. Let's see what is there. 3rd house is also about your valor, your courage, communication, mask, media, printing, siblings, your neighbor. What you will notice now when Mercury will give away the retrograde motion, and that suddenly all your schedule, okay, will come back into order. Whatever you are scheduled for, everything will come into place now. Mercury will also restore your timing, and now you can foresee the actual plan that you have been drawing for a long time and it was not happening. Now things will start happening for you. During this period, you will also see staying at home. So it happens that, you know, that relaxing all day, staying away from the outside world. But at times you may also feel that you should take a trip here and there, because it's the 3rd house, but it will take you for a short journey also. 12th house, as I told you, is a house which is very private, isolation. You want to just be with yourself. Okay. You will get fame, name, money, progress at work. Financially, your expenses may be a little high and you may be a little spendthrift during this period. What this Mercury transit provided you was utter confusion. All this while you are under complete confusion. You try now to understand why the confusion was there. It was there because Mercury was going retrograde. In your personal life, you are getting very generous, very happy. You are, and especially you are very happy in a gathering with your friends and your family, and you will be participating in functions that are happening around you. Health wise, I think you will feel very fit and fine, both physically and mentally as well. Overall, the time is favorable for you. You can leave all the hassles of the past and now move ahead. You please direct your energy, bring it back to the routine that you have lost the most of it. The next sign we shall be talking about is a sign of Leo. See, Mercury rules your 11th house, the house of income, house of fulfillment of desire, and the lord of your second house also. And it is now getting into the second house of money, wealth, family, speech. During this period, you will feel like stepping out of your shell or breaking the cocoon, coming out of the egg and achieving what you deserve. You may even have new concepts, ideas coming to you. You're gaining knowledge, maybe through studies, by reading some good books or educating yourself. And if you're a student, concentrating on your studies. You may also have lost your mind trying to retain anything that you have learned. This was happening when Mercury was retrograde. And that because Mercury was giving you some jerks. People were like, Leos were also forgetting the essential knowledge also. So you, all the time that you had the expertise over, you were losing that, you know, and you thought, hey, all that I have learned, I'm losing. It's not like that. It was just because Mercury was going retrograde, so you were feeling that. Now this is a good time to be careful about your finance and make proper investment if you want to, with help of expert advices that you can gain from some people who have the knowledge, and you may get some profit out in the long run. You can also plan on cutting down your ongoing expenses and increasing your income. So I would say you need to rebudget yourself. Now, you are now for a treat, because now that you are living in Mercury direct, everything you are learning not only has the ability to stick, it's about to take you to a new level of intelligence now. In this period, you might also get involved into religious activity as well. And you may go for long journeys also, from which you will benefit. In personal life, I think things are happy, a very happy time you will be spending. Health-wise also, you will be energetic, and physically, mentally, both physically and mentally, I see that it's a good period health-wise. Next sign is Virgo. Now, Virgo is a sign which is ruled by Mercury itself. So, it is the first house and the 10th house that is ruled by Mercury. Now, you know, the first house is all about your personality, yourself, your image, your characteristic. Now, you are the one who tried very hard over the past few weeks to accomplish something, and time after time what had happened with you was Mercury was not allowing you to, and it was better idea for you to sit into confusion. So you were just into confusion and you were waiting for something to happen, but nothing was happening. Now during this period when Mercury will go direct, you will see that now you are into that motion. Now you will see that you can communicate very well. You can speak a lot wherever required, of course. You will be going and spending a lot of time in social networking sites, and you may be interested in some gadgets as well. You will win over every situation that you come across. Financially, the period is favorable for you, and you will make a smart investment during this time. You have lost some money during the retrograde Mercury, and now Mercury is direct, so you will certainly find that not only your finances are back on track, but also that you are getting calls from people who used to drop your calls and was not facing you. Also, I see that in your personal life, you are becoming very social. You are planning for get-togethers. You are seeing your friends, your family. In married life also, everything is very cordial. Health-wise, you will feel very fit, energetic, and whatever you want to accomplish, this is a very good time for you. Since you are back online now, so to speak, it is a time that whatever comes to your mind, take the risk and do it, and you will see that everything is falling in place. The next sign is Libra. See, for Libra also, understand that Mercury is going to just come into your sign on the 2nd of November. It rules your 9th house and the 12th house. Now, and it is going to be in the 12th house. Now, 12th house is about expenses, expenditure, salvation, isolation, foreign settlement, foreign journey, all those things. There is a huge chance that, you know, maybe that you will spend some extra money and then you will feel, no, I shouldn't have done it. But then those expenses shall be only till the 2nd of November. So Mercury was actually making you spend money, and now you know your mistakes and you will learn from your mistakes how to control your expenses. Those old ghost which was there is now back into the closet. You would be interested in spending time alone, 12th house. So, and you'll be very spiritual in nature. You will be spiritually inclined also, and you will start learning few things as far as maybe yoga, meditation, something of that sort. Professionally, I feel that you will be doing very well, but there might be some loss of work or responsibility during this period, because 12th house will definitely play its role. You may also succeed in going to a foreign journey during this time. Financially, the expenses will be a little on a higher side, hence you have to be a little cautious about it. Now, in your personal life, I would request you not to hide anything from your friends because they are going to help you if you need something, like, you know. So if you need some help, please come out and speak it out. Now is your chance to do something great. So for Librans, it's a good time for you. Now is a chance that you can do a business, you can make money, and you will really be very creative. Massively created, I would say, creative. Health wise, maybe there is some medical expenses also for the family members, if not for you, but nothing major that I should caution you about. Next sign is Scorpio. Mercury is the lord of your 11th house and is turning direct in the 11th house. It is also the ruler of your 8th house. 8th house is of transformation. 11th house is fulfillment of desire, social circle, and it is gain. So during this time, you will earn through multiple sources. So money is coming from multiple sources for you. For Lagna as well as Moon Rashi, make sure. This is the time that you step into the present. Stay in present. Don't look into past. Don't even plan too much in future also. You will do very well on a professional front as well. And you will be praised by your superiors and seniors. Financially, this period is going to offer you some profit from various sources. And your past investment will get some dividends. Your finances will go on a rise, but you will also spend too much money trying to fulfill some of your desires as well. Personal life, things are going very happy, and you will be more involved with your friends during this time, and you will be also busy socializing with them. A lot of parties and all is there. Okay. Married people, I see that, you know, average time. Health wise, fit and fine, all well, there's nothing to worry about it. Next sign is Sagittarius. For Sagittarius, Mercury is the lord of your 7th house and your 10th house. Both are the Kendra houses, and it is getting direct in your 10th house. 10th house is about your career, your profession, your name, your fame. During this time, your level of enthusiasm will be on top, and you will be keeping all the focus on your career and work more confidently over it. Finally, you will be able to speak your mind, your heart out confidently as ever. And finally, you will be able to speak your mind without hesitation. So earlier you were hesitating, now it is very confidently. Now, Mercury, when it was retrograde, it was like, you know, every word that you were speaking out from your mouth was maybe out of anger, some harsh word, you were hurting people, and you have ruined some important contacts also. Now, the respect will be restored back, and you will also have full recognition of from your seniors and from your colleagues. During this period, I also see that this is a suitable period, and there are chances that you may get a hike or promotion, hike in the salary or job promotion. You may even expect bonus. It's a time for bonus also, Diwali bonus. Your personal life, your married life will be good. There would be chances of there, but there is some chances of some misunderstanding, as you will be very much occupied with your profession, and hence you won't be able to give quality time, and that could create a little misunderstanding. Health wise, you should have to take proper care of your health, as there are chances of extra work pressure that may mentally stress you out. So you need some time to play also. Next sign is Capricorn. Now for Capricorn, Mercury rules your 6th house and it rules your 9th house, and now it is in your 9th house of luck, religion, fortune, spirituality, mentor, guru, all these. So I see there will be a support by luck, development of good communication skill for you. You will be able to impress people with your with you being around, your communication also. If there is one thing that you really like to see yourself, okay, is that you are now very elegant and you are going with a lot of grace, and you will pull up the socks now and will do very well. There is an advice for you, not to be overconfident. Don't be overconfident, remain cautious, your communication to avoid any harsh word. So don't use harsh word because that may create some misunderstanding or bring some conflicts. Financially, there is a if there is any property related issues going on in your life, this is the best time to resolve it. Under this is a favorable situation for you now. There may be some expenses incurred in religious functions at home. Maybe it's a festival time, so you may spend some good amount of money. Health wise, I personally feel that you will remain good with your health, but keep a check on your father's health. Yes, father's health could be a little, may face some minor issues, I suppose. Also that I see that, you know, when your Mercury was getting it was into a retrograde motion, lot of your things were very clumsy. The meetings were not happening. You were not able to fulfill your commitments. But now things are getting back into track. Next sign is Aquarius. Now Aquarius, it is the lord of your 5th house and the 8th house, and it will be direct in the 8th house of occult, of mysticism, of sudden gains and loss, of inheritance, a dark house, secrecy, hidden things. So now, what did the retrograde was all about? Now it gave you a gift of self-doubt. When it was into the retrograde motion, you were doubting yourself and you had a lot of inhibitions in you. While now what will happen, when it will get direct on the 18th, you will see that you are becoming or being very spontaneous, because now you are believing that, you know, what your life needs is to have fun, to have excitement. Mercury will give you a twist of ideas and will whatever you brought when it was in the retrograde motion was nervousness and mistake. All those things are now going away. Now you are into a better. Also professionally, I see that, you know, a lot of work is coming to you and you're getting desired result also. Time is very favorable if you are a student and if you are into the field of research, because 8th house is all about research, especially people doing some thesis, PhD and those things. Financially, the spirit is also going to give you good profit and sudden gains in the form of inheritance also. In relationship with your in-laws, because 8th house is your in-laws also, in-laws will be very good and you will be spending some quality time with them as well. During this period, you may also have some favors from your in-laws as well. Married life will remain average, and there are chances of some minor conflicts, that is okay, avoidable. natives who are people who are single, those who are not married, don't get into a relationship right now during this period, because this is not a favorable period. Wait for some time. Health wise also, because it is the 8th house, you need to take good care of your health as well, because there is a chances of minor injury, and especially there could be some problem with ENT, your ear, nose and throat. You have to take care of that also. The last sign in the zodiac belt, we come to an end with Pisces. Now for Pisces, Mercury rules your 4th and the 7th house, and it will go direct on the 18th of October in your 7th house of marriage, partnership, business partnership. So what? You have been for a very long time, you have been bogged down with the ineffective Mercury retrogression. You always felt like giving up. I cannot take it any further. Whatever you were doing were getting very disruptive. And now also you must have realized that your phone, even your mobile phone also was getting some trouble to you. Communication was not happening. You were typing something and the message was not going through. All these possibilities were also there. Now your schedules were not getting proper. Whatever you were mailing, the mails were not going, or if it was going, you were finding, oh, I did a mistake in this and that. All these are now getting over, and now you will see that your business or partnership now is getting better. Communication is getting better. Good profits are coming to you in business. Your relation with your partner is getting better and becoming stronger. If you are into a job, you'll be very fortunate and you will get good income, good gains through this period also. There are also chances that you may initiate a new business, a new plan, and you will crack some new deals in your maybe in your career. And this deals will be cracked only because of your communication. Your communication will be par excellent now. Financially, the period is favorable for you, and you will be spending money on having some vacations along with your better half. In married life, disputes will be over, and you will be focusing on coordinating with your at home also and with your life partner also. Health wise, I think will remain average, good. Only if you can physically work, do some exercise regularly and keep a proper diet to remain fit and healthy. So friend, this was all about all the 12 lagnas, right from Aries to the sign of Pisces. If you did like this video, give it a like, share this video with your friends, colleagues and relatives. Subscribe to my channel if you haven't still, and join my membership if you want to help me out. Thank you so much. Stay blessed.